Bishop Lewis Henry Ford of the Church of God in Christ, like his mentor, Bishop Charles Harrison Mason, founder of the Church of God in Christ in 1895, today is one of the largest African-American Pentecostal organizations in America. Bishop Ford was trained as his national public relations director to always involve the white political figures of your city to keep interactive relationships with City Hall. Bishop Ford kept with this early tradition of Bishop Charles Harrison Mason, who would, at his national meetings in Memphis, Tennessee in the 30s and 40s, have Bishop Mason as his national public relations director invite mayors, senators, governors to Bishop Mason's to his civic night services. This would always be dedicated to highlight political figures long before most African-American religious groups interacted with segregated whites in political arenas. Bishop Lewis Henry Ford, mentor by Bishop Charles Harrison Mason, who had appointed him as bishop in Chicago's near Northside in the 50s. Bishop Charles Harrison Mason established this trend within his national organization by interacting with political governments long before African-American denominational leaders did. For example, in 1917, Bishop Charles Harrison Mason wrote President Woodrow Wilson a telegram requesting an audience with him surrounding African-American organizations' position concerning World War I, being a conscientious objector. This resulted in him having a meeting at the White House with President Wilson's with his staff of the Selective Service. When he had the meeting with the Selective Service, Wilson's cabinet agreed, according to his Christian faith, that he would not have to bear arms. Mason developed a document that he shared with the members of his African American movement that when they went before them to present the conscientious objector position, they had an official document from the organization stating that they would not have to enlist in World War I. This early exposure of Bishop Mason's dialoguing with high officials caused him to be investigated by the FBI for his position as being an African American that believed in the 14th Amendment of the Constitution of the United States. Later in 1918, despite President Wilson's support of Bishop Mason's Christian position to not take up arms, according to his Christian faith, the American Jim Crow mentality of the South could not take an African-American Church of God in Christ, African-American presenting a letter to their parole or their, not their parole, but to their actual sites where they would not have to enlist in World War I. Because of this, Mason's name became spread abroad nationally. And by this reason, the FBI began to investigate Bishop Charles Harrison Mason and tried to try him for treason against the United States. He also, even though he had gotten permission from President Woodrow Wilson, the FBI still proceeded with their court case. The position of the military later on today involves the historical case of Mason versus the United States government in 1918 to 1919, with the investigation of the FBI and the actual court case taking place in Paris, Texas in 1919. But Mason actually, with his attorneys, won the case against the United States government. The heart of African American protest for civil rights stated within the African American religious movement along. This happened long before Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s civil rights movement. By this established trend within Bishop Mason having a more direct approach to government officials, rather than having fear of most African-American leaders, instead of him fearing their retaliation, he decided to dialogue directly with governmental officials. This trend was established with Bishop Lewis Henry Ford, the Chicagoan here. He established a very good relationship with Mayor Richard J. Daley and many other governmental officials. Bishop Ford's job was to bring together political and religious leaders and allow them to have a voice to be able to share with his clientele. Bishop Ford, as early as the 50s, would have Mayor Richard J. Daley kick off his conferences surrounding the Church of God in Christ and their churches. He was located at 45th and Wabash at the historical St. Paul Church of God in Christ. In 1955, Bishop Lewis Henry IV preached the eulogy of Emmett Till, who became known historically as the sacrificial lamb of the civil rights movement in America. The parents of Emmett Till were members of Forge Southside Chicago Church at St. Paul Church of God in Christ. The death of Emmett Till moved the nation of America to begin to protest senseless lynching of African-American males for years. And this teenager that was murdered and mutilated while visiting his grandmother in Money, Mississippi, when his mother sent him from the Chicago South Side to be there for the summer. Bishop Ford also sold the Clark House later on, the oldest house in Chicago, to Mayor Richard J. Daley, so that Chicago would own one of its oldest houses still in existence, because Bishop Ford had the foresight as a preservationist to preserve the history of Chicago's founding fathers long before they established the Illinois State Historical Association and the city's Historical Preservation Commissions, which were organized in the 60s to rethink for them to be able to take back within the urban core the historically preserved architectural history of Chicago. Bishop Ford, known for establishing relationships with political machinery of Chicago, early on directed He developed a close friendship with Mayor Richard J. Daley and became close friends with his family to the degree that when he, at his funeral, he actually escorted his wife. Bishop Ford, a great political figure in Chicago in America, knew most presidents from Truman all the way to Clinton, who he invited Clinton to his national conference in 1994 when he became elevated to National Presiding Bishop of the Pentecostal African American Religious Group while residing in Chicago. President Clinton attended Bishop Ford's invitation, the first president of the United States to be invited to a African American religious denomination service. He came because Dr. Martin Luther King spoke at Ford's organization's world headquarters the day before he was assassinated in 1968. It was at Bishop Ford's National Organization's World Headquarters, the historic Mason Temple. In the 40s, this building was one of the largest facilities that Mason had built that African Americans had actually built from the ground up. Dr. Martin Luther King utilized this building many times for his rallies in the Memphis, Tennessee area. And it just so happens the day before he was assassinated that he actually had used Mason, the historic Mason Temple, the world headquarters of the Church of God in Christ, for his final rally. His last speech to the world was, "I've been to the mountaintop," but this particular facility is where he actually gave his last speech to the world. The son of Mayor Richard Daley held a celebration for Ford as a Chicagoan who had represented the city well by becoming elevated to this prestigious office. Ford was always a very political individual as a minister and was a trendsetter. In addition to this, Bishop Lewis Henry Ford, a highway after his death was dedicated to Bishop Lewis Henry Ford, the Bishop Lewis Henry Ford Expressway here in Chicago. As was stated early in the development of protests and support of the African American religious experience within our culture, you will see that there is a strengthening of it within the embodiment of the African American church. In 1786, 200 years before Rosa Parks' protest, Richard Allen and Absalom Jones refused to be treated differently than their white counterparts as Methodists in a Philadelphia service. They decided to form the first African American church solely operated by African Americans. The end result was that they ended up forming the first African Methodist Episcopal Church in America, and they ended up having to go to court in order to have the right to oversee their finances of their worship services. The start of this particular thing is what gives individuals the right to worship African American churches all throughout the city of Chicago and throughout America because of Richard Allen's court case, Allen versus the United States. One of the things that Allen did that was very, very important